I'm Michael Campbell, and I'm the founder of Glossika. The reason why we started this company was really to focus on how we can solve the problem of getting people to break through to fluency. Most products on the market, they're not worried about, you know, getting people to the fluency level. And so we've actually defined what fluency is, and we've helped people break through to fluency many times. What you'll find here in Asia, most of the problem with a lot of the students is they're very good at memorizing vocabulary, and they can pass lots of vocabulary tests, but they're very, very bad at actually creating coherent sentences and putting those words into sentences. So when you get sentences, you have the syntax, the order, also a lot of grammatical stuff that goes in there. And so this is kind of confusing for the student. So memorizing a lot of vocabulary seems to be the easy way to kind of get a false sense of fluency, but it's not real fluency. The way we define fluency is being able to say a full sentence in one breath. It flows from beginning to end. So, like I just said, a lot of the systems out there are focused on vocabulary. We actually take a different approach. We focus on syntax. And syntax, what that really means is the position of all of the different elements in the sentence, where your subjects and your verbs and your objects are in the sentence. And so we have a list of a whole bunch of different kind of syntactic structures. We map them out to all the different languages. And then there, each of those syntactic structures, they have placeholders where all of the nouns go. And so a lot of it is really driven by functional words, like verbs. And so instead of focusing on teaching our learners a whole lot of nouns, we try to focus more on the functional words and get more verbs out there. And so when I come across a different language learning method that kind of teaches me the numbers, the days of the week, or, you know, even animals, I just think, wow, this isn't really going to do a whole lot for me. Let's take, for example, numbers and days of the week, and really important concepts, but you can actually teach those in the context of full sentences rather than just memorizing, you know, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Because when you start speaking another language, they usually have to change depending on the context that they appear in those sentences. There's a lot of grammar attached to things. When you're actually practicing the syntactic structures, you're not really aware that you're doing that because we kind of do that in the background for the user. But when they're practicing all of these syntactic structures, they start to recognize the patterns. And when the patterns start to emerge, then they start to gain fluency. They can now use these patterns and replace the words with their own words that they want to use in other situations away from the practice session. So Glossika really focuses on syntax to build fluency. So based on our definition of fluency, if you're able to get through a whole sentence flowingly, then the way you're able to do that is with the syntactic patterns. So when you're using Glossika, you may not realize or notice any of the syntax that's behind the scenes working for you, but you should be able to pick up on the patterns. And so picking up on that patterns now means that you're able to use these same patterns outside of this training session anywhere else. And so that gives you a sense of fluency that it's really hard to get when all you have is just vocabulary. So the way that we actually deliver this, we deliver it through our pipeline called Glossika Spaced Repetition. And so this spaced repetition thing, we've been working on this for many, many years. It's an algorithm that really focuses on how often you're supposed to get exposure to certain sentences and patterns over a period of time, a period of several days. And this is timed together with your sleep patterns. And so it's supposed to build up your memory, not just of the vocabulary, because we're not really focused on vocabulary, we're really focused on the syntactic patterns. When people go to sleep at night, there's something that happens called long-term potentiation, or it's memory consolidation. So your brain kind of takes all of the events that happened during that day and says, yeah, a lot of that stuff is sort of unimportant, like it just doesn't seem important to me, and it throws out the garbage. And so the things that get left over are things that seem to have some sort of connection with your past. It's like, oh, well, something happened today that kind of seems more important and it has more anchors in the mind. Maybe it has sight or smell or visual anchors and things like this. And so those kinds of memories tend to stay in longer. So the reason why memories are staying in there longer is because you have some sort of past anchor. And so if we're able to create those anchors over a period of several days and increase the amount of times that they actually appear in that spaced repetition format, then we're pretty sure that those that those patterns will start to emerge naturally in the brain. The brain will recognize the patterns and will start using the patterns and be able to apply them in real life. So our original technology was based off of the Glossika Space Repetition, or GSR, and we've made a huge update to that this year in 2017. So a couple things that we've done is we've tagged all of the data that we have in our database with the syntactic tags. And now we're using machine learning to actually learn how to tag all this data. So that allows us to really scale out both across languages and more in depth with the languages that we already have. So we can add a whole lot more content-rich material to the platform. And the second thing is we developed an algorithm that actually sorts all of these the content of all of these languages from simple to complex. And so that sorting allows us to get the syntactic patterns aligned and delivered to the user. Now, when the users are using our platform, they provide some feedback, and that actually sorts provides even an even better sort for these learners. And so what you get is a tailored-made solution for every single learner and for that learner's particular learning speed. So if Sally over here is a slower learner and David's a faster learner, they're going to get their material at a different rate of speed, but hopefully for both sides, they're actually going to be learning the same concepts and gaining the same skills in roughly the same amount of time. So Glossika is one of a kind in that we can actually address the languages that are not actually written down. So this means that a lot of languages, I mean, there are 7,000 languages in the world, and most of them are not written. They are spoken languages, and a lot of them are dialects. And so you have situations where a certain country has developed a standard language from all of the weird dialects that exist in that country because they're really hard to communicate between them. So in the 19th century, you had Italy create a standard Italian language, which all Italians now use to communicate with each other, but they don't necessarily use in their own hometowns. They all have their own language that they use. The same thing happens in Finland. And so when you get our Glossika course, the actual language you're learning with Glossika, for example, with Finnish, is the colloquial version of the language. Now here in Taiwan, we also have languages that are spoken and not normally written down, like Taiwanese and Hakka and other forms of the Chinese language. There are all kinds of Chinese dialects. And so one of our initial goals is, can we actually build a system that can teach people any spoken language in the world? And can we bring them to fluency? So that was one of the very first goals that we laid out. And so we've been able to achieve that. We're able to map all of these spoken languages to the syntax and sort it and then deliver it on our platform. Now you can learn languages like Taiwanese or Hakka or Cantonese or even the colloquial version of Finnish or Egyptian Arabic. And these are languages that are not normally written. You can learn them directly through the audio training on Glossika. This also allows us, and one of our visions here at Glossika is to actually let people who speak minority languages be able to learn any majority language they want. So for example, in India, you have a huge population of people there who may not speak English or may not have good command of English, but they really want to do business with China or they want to learn Chinese. They're interested in learning Chinese. So how do they learn Chinese? Do they have to learn English first? What if there are no good materials available in their local language in India? They might speak Bengali, they might speak Hindi or Tamil, but they might need some really good materials in their own language to learn Chinese. If we build such what I believe is a great solution for building fluency, I want to make it available to even those people who speak, for example, Bengali. Now they can learn Chinese directly from their own language. We can also do the same for minority languages. Let's say they speak Egyptian dialect, I can teach them Taiwanese. If they speak Taiwanese dialect, I can teach them Egyptian dialect directly between the two. And so the power here is that we're actually connecting people originally that they had no way to connect with each other before. And so that's one of our long-term visions. We can actually go into countries, maybe in Africa, we can allow doctors access to the local languages there, perform surgeries and be able to communicate with people, help save lives. And we can also allow the people in those smaller communities learn the major languages of the world as well. The technology is moving along at a really fast pace these days. And so there's a unique opportunity right now to jump in where we can provide Glossika's technology together with the new AR and VR formats. We can create immersive environments. These are exactly the kinds of tools that hotels and food and beverage companies are looking for to improve their frontline customer service. And we make those immersive experiences much more effective for the user so that they're actually able to provide their services directly from experiences that they have directly in that immersive environment. And we're really excited about pioneering this kind of technology.